One of the challenges when you're defining the core needs is you have to strip out what may be a design solution and try to understand more why do you have the requirement in place. And so, for example, we had to, when we looked at a lot of our interface requirements in the SSP, our interface requirements document for the commercial vehicles is the SSP 50808. And so you'll hear me referring to that. So under SSP 50808, we had to really split out the requirements into three sections, where previously we used to say, you have to be able to fly this amount of cargo or this amount of capability and have it be a very descriptive on bags and everything else. We were silent on that. What we said instead was, here's the interface requirements that you need to be able to fly a vehicle to the International Space Station. Here's the safety requirements that are required for a vehicle that's coming into proximity operations with the space station. And here's the requirements that are required for you to be able to meet, for you to be able to actually berth and interface with the station. And then we had to strip out everything else, right? And so where the International Space Station had, their requirement set up to that point was a treed document set of multiple layers of documents that really were based on performance standards and multitude levels of requirements and interfaces. We had to kind of boil those all down to this COTS IRD, which is about 330 requirements that then were made up of those three big categories of requirements. And so every time people would come in and say, for example, I have this level of even things like interfaces from a crew perspective. So we had to go look at, why really were we putting in requirements for payload operations or other things if they weren't really going to have a requirement for that payload. If it was a capability that they wanted to have at some point, then it would be a new requirement to add. So those were in the original station requirement set, but we stripped those out and just had the core set of requirements that were needed for a vehicle to be interfacing with the space station, come into close proximity operations, and be able to safely interface and berth with the International Space Station.